Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Let's learn about two types of bond cleavage, homolytic cleavage and heterolytic cleavage. On the screen, we have two structures. These aren't complete structures, but they do highlight a carbon-chlorine bond. That carbon is attached to other things. I haven't shown them, but it has four bonds and a full octet. When you see a structure like this, you might think about making a carbocation. To form the carbocation, the carbon-chlorine bond would break by having both electrons in the sigma bond go to the chlorine atom. That would form a chloride ion. Let's show all the valence electrons. And a carbocation. We broke a bond, and we broke it through something called a heterolytic cleavage. In a heterolytic cleavage, electrons move together in pairs. We broke the CCl bond by moving both electrons in the sigma bond together to the chlorine. For introductory organic chemistry, almost all the reactions involve moving electrons as a pair. It's how we moved electrons in the SN2, the SN1, the E2, and E1. For all the common addition reactions, we moved electrons in pairs. These are all heterolytic bond cleavages. Heterolytic cleavages often involve ions, and we've certainly seen a lot of ions. Wow, so we've been doing heterolytic cleavages this whole time. What else is out there? Well, there's also homolytic cleavage. On the bottom of the screen, we have the same structure. To break the CCl bond in a homolytic fashion, we will move the two bonding electrons to opposite sides of the bond. We'll use a special arrow. It's called a fishhook arrow to indicate that we're removing just one electron. As with all mechanistic arrows, we start the arrow where the electron is and point the arrow to where the electron is going. We move one electron to carbon and the other to chlorine. The result of this homolytic cleavage is the creation of two neutral radicals. So again, we'll show all the valence electrons on chlorine and carbon. Homolytic cleavages are associated with radical reactions. Heterolytic cleavages are associated with ionic reactions. As we continue with radical reactions in this playlist, we will perform a lot of homolytic cleavages and use fishhook arrows to move the electrons. Remember that fishhook arrows are just for moving single electrons.